Hey guys, this is Hashim and this is Dr. Tell Me Why, a medical YouTube channel where I explain complex medical and scientific ideas simply in a fun way that everyone can understand. So I recently came across something that I just felt like I had to share with you guys. Since at least the 1950s, not a single case of schizophrenia has been identified among anyone who had been born blind. Not a single case. More recent studies and reviews have supported this idea and even suggested that the protection afforded by congenital blindness or blindness that's present at birth may also extend to protect against other forms of psychosis. Basically, those who are born blind appear to be a lot more resilient to schizophrenia than individuals with normal eyesight. And this fact is made even more interesting by the stark contrast to people who lose their sight or go blind later in life, who are actually at a heightened or increased risk of developing schizophrenia and other psychotic disorders. Schizophrenia is, of course, a brain disorder with symptoms including delusions, disordered thinking, and hallucinations. It also happens to be far, far more common than most people expect it to be, with its incidence approaching 1% internationally, meaning that it roughly affects 1 in every 100 people, or 2.2 million people in the United States alone, making it 2 times more common than Alzheimer's disease and 6 times more common than insulin-dependent diabetes. So you know, naturally this got me thinking, what was it about people who are born blind that, you know, conferred this seeming immunity against schizophrenia, and whether this could shed some light on the condition and teach us new and fascinating things about the human brain and how it works in health and in disease. I was floored and I think you will be too. People with schizophrenia have regularly been shown to have issues with their vision that often precede, meaning that they come before their first psychotic break or episode. These issues include things like unusual eye movements, problems with the retina, and an unusual blinking rate, among other things. If you think about it, vision is enormously complex and carries so much information or data about the world around us and the objects that are in it. We see color, shape, position, texture, depth, and motion. That's a lot to take in. And, you know, I think it would be absolutely crazy to expect our brains to process all of this visual information around the clock. I mean, our brains are powerful, but if I know anything, I know this. Our human brains are also incredibly lazy, and they love taking shortcuts. Which brings us to this new model of the Bayesian brain, where instead of processing every single bit and piece of visual information that is out there, your brain only picks the most important or the key parts and compares it to a pre-existing model that it has of the world, allowing it to make predictions about things like how far a certain object is or how a particular surface would feel should you touch it. And if those predictions end up being false, then no problem, because your brain will treat those predictions as prediction errors and use those prediction errors to change or to update its model. It's a bit like machine learning for the computer scientists among us. And this is largely the reason why optical illusions work so well. It's because optical illusions, they exploit these assumptions and these predictions that your brain makes about the world around it. And these assumptions and predictions are not always true. So, there is this new idea that the visual hallucinations and disturbances that we tend to associate with schizophrenia may actually be the result of a mismatch between perception, how the world actually is, and the internal model that individual has of the world, with an inability to identify errors and update that model. Think of it as two individuals from the extremes of the political spectrum coming together to argue. Because they are arguing, they're not really engaging with one another. And so, conflict starts to arise. And in schizophrenia, the conflict will manifest itself in the form of visual hallucinations. Now, you might be wondering what all of this has to do with blind people and how blindness confers protection against schizophrenia. So here's why. The scientists think that lacking visual inputs from birth prevents you from making assumptions about the world around you, preventing prediction errors and conflict, and thus creating a more stable worldview that's perhaps more resilient to hallucinations and psychosis. It's also well known that people who are born blind tend to have brains that overcompensate through a process known as neuroplasticity in other areas, so they may overdevelop certain skills and they also may strengthen other senses which are often compromised in people who suffer from schizophrenia. I personally feel like this is a good theory, because it explains why people who go blind or lose their sight later in life don't have that same level of protection against schizophrenia and psychotic disorders and are actually at an increased risk of developing them. Those people did have a visual input at one point in time, and they did have the time to construct a model of what the world looks like and make predictions and assumptions. And so when you deprive them of their vision, that model still remains, but without the input, and that can lead to things going haywire. They also did not have the time to develop and strengthen their own senses, which are believed to confer some level of protection against schizophrenia. This is really groundbreaking stuff, because it opens up new avenues in the treatment and in the diagnosis of schizophrenia. And this Bayesian model of how the brain works changes the way that we think about the brain and how it perceives the world around it, and also how it processes information. If you think about it, every single one of our brains kind of manufactures an alternative reality. Regardless of whether we may be completely healthy or completely psychotic, we live in that alternative reality or simulation. And that alternative reality in all cases will be just a little bit off from the real world. And in most cases, that's completely fine, because so long as it's close enough, no problem should arise. However, once that alternative reality begins to diverge just a little bit too much, that's when we can expect to see
problems.
I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this. I publish weekly medical and science videos, and so if this is the kind of content that you want to support here on YouTube, then I recommend you subscribe. Can't wait to see you all next week, and until then, you can watch my video about prosopagnosia to learn all about face blindness.